So that was the Sami Iwuku there. Now, if you've been following the election from 1992, you would notice that one of the regions they call the swing regions is the Western region. Now, it has swung from the NDC, who won it in 1992 and 1996, to the NPP winning it in 2000 and 2004. The NDC won it back from the NPP in the 2008 runoff and won it in 2012 again with 54.42%. So that is a region that somewhat indicates which political party actually takes the day. So we are going to that region, specifically Takoradi, where our reporter Kwesi Ejeanim managed to enter the Electoral Commission strong room in the Western region and filed this report.
It is 10:45 a.m., a day after the general elections, and I've come to the Western Regional EC office, which people would want to term as the strong room of the EC in the Western region. And as you can see behind me, these are officials from the various political parties who are here trying to verify the results that are coming from the various constituencies. But I have the regional EC boss, and I just want to find out from him how many certified results that have come in as at 10:40 a.m. On the second day of the general elections.
What can you tell me in terms of the number of collated, or should I say certified results that has come in?
So far, I have got results from 5 constituencies for both presidential parliamentary results. These are Ifeanyi Kwesimintim, Sekendi, Christia Honibali, Takwa Nswahim.
How many are left to go? And is it normal that, I mean, after 10:30, we're still waiting for, we've only received just 5?
Yeah, because of the terrain that we have in this region, it's very difficult to get the results early. We are expecting that by close of today, we'll get all the results from the 20 constituencies in the region.
Thank you, sir. So that is the situation here at the regional, Western Regional Office of the Electoral Commission. And as you can see, these are some of the regional representatives that are in the strong room trying to verify whatever is coming from the constituencies.
All right, so that was Kwesi Ejeanim there in the Western region. Now, he joins us again on the phone to give us updates on the figures coming in. Thanks for joining us, Ejeanim. Congratulations, by the way. I mean, having entered the EC's strong room to speak to the regional director. Can you tell us, what is the latest in terms of figures for the parliamentary and presidential? I mean, the regional EC boss mentioned Kwesi Mintim, for example, where, let me see, the NDC's Augustine Arthur was going head-to-head against Joseph Mensah of the NPP. What can you tell us about a place like Kwesi Mintim, for example? Do you have any results from that constituency?
Well, for your information, you know, the Efia Kwesimintim constituency used to be one constituency. Yeah. But as we speak, in this election, it has been split into two.
Yeah.
So we have the Efia constituency results, which is now certified and signed by the party representatives as well as the regional EC director.
Yeah.
And these are the figures for Efia constituency. For the presidential, the CPP had 55.
Okay.
NDP had 10. NDC 10,621. DPP 44. That is 446.
Okay.
NPP had 21,213. PNC 355. And the Independent Party candidate had 5. So from the FIA constituency presidential, NDC, NPP have won with 21,213 as against NDC's 10,621.
Okay, what about the parliamentary?
The parliamentary, again, NPP won here. 3 people contested. Michael Otu from the NDC had 11,995. NPP's candidate who won had 20,315. That is
so Joseph Kujo.
Joseph Kujo. He has won it.
Okay.
He's a new candidate. He's going for the second term.
All right.
So this is going to be his second term running, and he's won the seat for the NPP again. And then the NDC, CTP's IDP became third with 308.
Okay, so for the FWA constituency, the NPP has taken that. What about the Kwesi Mintim constituency?
As we speak, the Kwesi Mintim, we only have provisional, and which I don't want to go in there. We don't have the certified right now.
All
what
right.
is happening at the EC office is that when the results come, the provisional results from the collation center come to the regional office, EC is the last, the regional EC boss is the last person who puts his signature on it. And I'm telling you, the officials from the various political parties spend a lot of time. As we're speaking, about 12 collation results have come, but the officials from the various political parties are taking their time calling their guys from the collation center to verify what has been faxed to the office before they will put their signature on it. And until they put their signature on it, the EC boss has no chance to also put his hand, his signature on it for it to be a satisfactory result. So we have some of these results that are tricked in, but the people, if anybody wants to see anybody delaying the results, then it is the various political parties. They are delaying it, and not the EC, because EC only comes in to certify a result only when the officials from the various political parties in the EC's office have actually accepted what has come from the collation center. So EC is not the one who is doing the process. As you can inform, what I have witnessed, it is the political parties who are delaying the process, because they want to be very sure that what has been sent to them at the regional office is exactly what their officers saw it at the collision center. Now let me take you to Takwa.
Okay.
Takwa is a very interesting place. That place we have both the presidential and then the parliamentary certified results here. And over here, let me take you to the parliamentary. Parliamentary is where the popular said family, Jokoto, the popular NDC, actor and then the comedian, stood on behalf of the NDC. And he was able to get 24,044 votes. But the NPP candidate, George Mreku Duka, won the seat with 42,594.
Wow.
So Takwa Insawe, Kwame Jokoto, couldn't win the seat. These are all fresh candidates who came in to contest on their individual parties. We have the PPP also contesting and getting 1,621, as well as Justice Pam John from CPP, who had 206. But for the presidential, Takwa Insawe, again,
Can you please repeat those figures for Takwa Insawe, where Seth Kwame Jokoto of the NDC went against George Mreku Duka of the NPP? Can you kindly go over those figures again? Because I know that Kwame Jokoto is a very popular figure across the country, and people will want to know exactly how things turned out for him. Kindly go over those figures once more.
Yes. The NPP won the seat with 42,594.
Wow.
42,594. And Seth Kwame Jokoto of the NDC came second with 24,044. So we're looking about close to 10,000 difference of, close to 20,000 difference.
That's quite a wide margin. Staying on Takwa Insawe, what do you think accounted for Kwame Jokoto not being able to clinch that seat? Because from a lot of indication, people believe that, looking at his popularity to some extent and the party seeing that he ran on the ticket of the incumbent NDC, some people would have thought that he would have gained higher figures than he got.
Well, it's true. The issue is it wasn't so much about popularity.
Yeah.
If it were to be popularity contest, I'm sure Kwame Jokoto would have easily won. But
that's
this is about politics. And what I think did a trick for the NPP guy is that the NPP guy is a party man. He's a politician. I think he's been a former MC, municipal chief executive before. And they know him as a politician. Kwame Jokoto, until his decision to actually contest this seat, nobody knew him as a politician. So he had a popularity, but as to the area of politics, it didn't work for him. It didn't work for people. Maybe some also saw him not to be somebody that they can entrust the whole constituency to as their representative. And so I would say that maybe what led to this situation is the fact that people feel this MPP man is a true politician, and he might actually be able to do what they have to do.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Kwesi Jainim. That's our regional correspondent from the Western Region, one of the swing regions. We'll be coming back to you within the day to give us some more updates with regards to the results that are trickling in. We'll wait to see.